Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now, let us see about 100 concepts in organic chemistry. We are seeing it as episodes. This is the episode number 28. If you didn't watch previous episodes, I encourage you to go and see. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. Let us see the first question. Here you have cyclohexyl system with 3 methyl group. All are seen to each other. Here you have cyclohexane and attached with 3 methyl group. All these 3 methyl groups are in syn fashion. They given the chair configuration of them. So which one will fit the stability of them? So stable configuration they are asking. The all 4 structure differ in the axial or equatorial position. You have to find from the stability. So from the structure and possible answers, you might realize the question is really about structure versus stability. The answer is C. Let us see how. Here we have 4 structure. So we draw equal and normal planar form. We draw A, B, C, D. Here B and D are in the antiposition. So it is not definitely our answer. We have only between A and C. So if you look at A and C, more equatorial bonds are stable. But A have 2 axial and 1 equatorial bond. But C have 1 axial and 2 equatorial bond. So C is the most stable structure among those. Here the concepts you have to learn here is, the equatorial bonds are more stable than axial bonds. The structure with more equatorial bonds are stable. Then we have the next question. Next you have phenandrine kind of system. You have 2 methyl group. 1 benzene ring is on above the plane and methyl which is on below the plane. Here they given what is the configuration of them. This is a new configuration, whether they are P or M. The compound is really chiral or not. Or it has C2 symmetry or plane of symmetry. So from the structure and the possible 4 answers, you might realize the question is really about structure versus chirality. The answer is A. Let us see how. Here, if you look at the structure, it will be above and below. But really it is a spiral compound. It is called spirality. It is called spiral chirality. If you look at it, it's like DNA and RNA. How you find the configuration? Normally they are calling M and P. If the structure goes top to bottom clockwise means it's M. Anti-clockwise means it is B. Here you go top to bottom, it is anti-clockwise. It is called P there. So the spiral chirality, you can say axis chirality. There are the many ways you can call it. So the answer is A. Compound is chiral which has P configuration. Here the concepts you have to learn here is chirality due to spiraling. If the spiraling is from clockwise direction, it's called M. Spiraling is anti-clockwise, it is called P there. It is like R and S configuration, it's a spiral chirality. Then the next question, you have 5 member heterocyclic system with oxygen. You have 1 phenyl above, 1 phenyl below, 1 methyl above, 1 methyl below. So there are the 4 attachments. They are asking relationship between methyl groups, whether they are homotopic, meaning they are same, or diastereotopic, or enantiotopic, or constitutionally heterotopic. So from the structure and possible 4 answers, you might realize the question is really about symmetry versus topicity. The answer is A. Let us see how. Here let us draw in the 3-dimensional form rather than the planar form. So we draw it. It's a 5-member ring. It won't have envelope shape because of the hydroxygen atom. So the bond angle will not be tetrahedral. It will be just a kind of bent structure. The structure will be planar there. So 1 phenyl above, 1 phenyl below. 1 methyl above, 1 methyl below. So what really you will have is C2 axis with the methyl group. If the relationship is C2, it is a homotopic. So the answer is A. The methyl groups are homotopic to each other. Here the concepts you have to learn here is the planarity. If the cyclohexane have heteroatom, it will be mostly planar. If the compound have C2 relationship, mean you have homotopicity. Then let us see the next question. You have the tricyclic compound. They are asking IUPAC name. What is the IUPAC name? Whether the IUPAC name is tricyclopentane with different attachment 111 with 24, 111 with 1315, or 110113 attachment, or 111 with 13 attachment. So basically, it is a pentane with different attachment. So from the structure and possible IUPAC name, the question is really about tricyclic alkene versus its IUPAC naming. The answer is D. Let us see how. Here the answer is tricyclo-11013 pentane. So let us draw from step by step. First carbon we draw, it's 1. Second carbon we draw with second cycle, so it's again 1. Then we have bridged carbon, it's again 1. So 111. Then you have the connection there. It doesn't have any carbon, so it is 0. Then you have to start numbering. The numbering start next to the main ring, so number 1, 2, 3. So the connection really start from 1, 3 connection. So the superscript shows the connection there. So the answer is D, tricyclo-11013 pentane. Here the concepts you have to learn here is the connections. The 1, 3 connection is important. So you have to know how to number the tricyclic system. Then the naming. The naming always you start from high number of carbon to low number of carbon. Here you start from 1, then move to 0. Then the next question. They are given the alkene plus bromine. You have the bromine addition there. They are asking which orbital involved in the first step. Whether CC bond donates electron to sigma star, or BR donates electron to CC, or CC donates electron to sigma BRBR, or NBR non-bonding electron donated to pi CC double bond. So which orbital involved you have to guess. So from the equation and possible charge transfers, you might realize the question is really about electron donation in antibonding or bonding orbitals. The answer is A. Let us see how. Here the bond breaking happened during the reaction. Bond breaking means you are donating electron to the antibonding orbital. Because the bond order is a calculation from bonding minus antibonding. So if you add more electron to antibonding, definitely the value will decrease. The bond order will decrease. That's why the bond breaking. So clearly the increasing the electron in the antibonding decrease the bond order. Here bromine-bromine bond is breaking and the possible donation from the pi bond. So the electron donating from the pi bond, which is pi orbital, to the bromine and bromine bond. So the electron donating from the pi orbital to antibonding sigma star orbital. Here the concepts you have to learn here is bond order. If the electron added to the antibonding mean always decrease in the bond order. Second thing is you have to guess which bond is breaking during the reaction. Based on that you have to guess the orbitals. That's all from this episode. I hope it was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. Stay tuned for next episode.